This November, John D. Porcari, the Port Envoy for the Biden-Harris Supply Chain Disruption Task Force, visited the Port of Long Beach. During his visit to Total Terminals International, he had the opportunity to see firsthand how a 24/7 operation works, as TTI was the first terminal to pilot a third shift to help alleviate congestion earlier this year.
The single most important element is more 24/7 operation. And it starts with the ports, but it's really important. It's the entire goods movement chain. So the ports here may be the most visible part, the goods movement chain that's clogged up right now. But it's the middle mile. It's the rail and trucking part of it. It's the warehouses, the distribution centers, the fulfillment centers. All of them need to be more 24/7. And those are the conversations we're having right now.
At the Port of Long Beach, Executive Director Mario Cordero has for several years been championing 24/7 and other short and long-term solutions to reduce bottlenecks, improve operations, and build a sustainable future.
And like I always like to say, people shop 24/7. So that Amazon state of mind, as you know, that I discussed a couple years ago, which is about speed and cargo velocity, that's what we're trying to get to so that we don't come into a situation where we're talking about cargo volatility. So I think to use a cliche, crisis brings opportunities. We have an opportunity to see how we transform the supply chain to, again, create more fluidity, efficiency, and going forward, we'll see how we do this. But the good news, I think we need to expand the gate operations.
Operational improvements and collaboration among port stakeholders, coupled with the ongoing dedication of port workers to move cargo as our economy rebounds, are starting to make a difference.
And we're making progress. So just by one measure, the number of containers, imported containers, that are dwelling 9 days or longer on dock here is down almost 30%. And that's through some focused, combined, joint efforts with the cargo owners, the terminal operators, the leadership at the port, the trucking community, and the railroads.
For more information, visit polb.com.